Restrictions apply. Minimum term agreement required. FLEF000279. TNACL2006. AZROC307346. CACSLV1028256. ORCCB1999-39. Call for details.
Hello, beautiful. I'm Amy Arrett, founder of Madison Reed, a hair color company I named after my daughter. One of the things I value most in life is time. Time to spend with my daughter, time to spend with family, and the time I put into my company that's reinventing the way women color their hair. The busiest, most successful women I know use Madison Reed, the amazing hair color hack. In under an hour and for less than $25, Madison Reed delivers gorgeous, shiny, multi-dimensional, healthy-looking hair with an ammonia-free formula. You'll look like you just came from a salon, but the reality is you have more me time to do what you love. Things get busy. Let us take care of you and your hair. Find your perfect shade at madison-reed.com and get 10% off plus free shipping on your first color kit. Use code HELLO. That's code HELLO. Try it. Love it. That's the beauty of Madison Reed.
New Jersey, 101.5 instant weather. On the watch for a few showers and thunderstorms here this afternoon. Mostly 70s, but a few 80s expected in the southwest. Scattered showers and storms will continue through the night tonight. Lows 65 to 70. Warm and sticky on Friday. Scattered showers and storms in the forecast. Highs 82 to 88. And more showers and storms expected Saturday. Highs 76 to 83. Cooler temperature Sunday with a chance of rain. Sunday's high 70 to 75. From the Edison Heating and Cooling Weather Desk, I'm meteorologist Richard Webb.
In Keensburg at 69, Logan 73, East Windsor 71. Traffic and weather every 15 minutes on New Jersey 101.5. New Jersey weather made possible by At Home Recreation, now offering their lowest pricing on 2018 pool models. Save $200 to $2,000 off New Jersey's market price. Spas and hot tubs at tremendous savings, plus for a limited time, 20% off pool installation prices. Visit athomerecreation.com for a store near you.
New Jersey 101.5, our own radio station. Not New York, not Philadelphia. Proud to be New Jersey.
To talk to Governor Phil Murphy, call now, 1-800-283-1015. Live video now at nj1015.com and on our Facebook page. Phil Murphy is not responsible for last year's massive hike in the gas tax, nor for another hike in the same tax this fall. But he won't stop it, defending the need for drivers to pay more.
That gas tax feeds the Transportation Trust Fund. It allows us to dig out of the mess that we've been in and reclaim that space that we used to dominate, which is a state that really works and gets people around.
The most pressing issue for the governor right now is avoiding a government shutdown, and that may not be easy. Senate President Steve Sweeney, a fellow Democrat, has vowed not to allow the tax hikes that Murphy has been demanding.
We speak either literally directly in groups or individually or our teams all the time. I'm very optimistic we're going to work something out.
Another critical issue in this budget is school funding. Murphy and the legislature have not been on the same page when it comes to funding our schools, how much local districts will get, and the reliance on higher property taxes to possibly fund it. Can lawmakers agree on a funding formula that won't result in higher property taxes? Can Murphy win the support of voters already burdened by high taxes? Will a budget deal be reached by the end of next month to avoid a government shutdown? Plus, your calls as New Jersey 101.5 presents Ask the Governor. Governor Phil Murphy, welcome back to New Jersey 101.5. Very happy to have you here.
Eric, thank you very much for having me.
You're looking a little tan. Were you down the shore this past weekend?
That's the Irish tan I've got going.
Yeah, right, right.
I was, actually. I had. It's a great opportunity to kick off the summer. I open up in Point Pleasant Beach. Spent a meaningful amount of time in places like Long Branch, Asbury Park, Belmar, Seaside Heights, Seaside Park. Other than a little nasty weather that came through,
yeah.
It was a great kickoff to the summer, particularly Friday and Saturday.
We had some vendors tell us that it was, despite the weather, one of the best kickoff weekends they've had in years.
Yeah, so Friday and Saturday were home runs, and I was out there in a lot of those places on Sunday,
yeah.
And I was surprised by how many folks were out there. A lot of New Jerseyans, but a lot of out-of-staters visiting as well, but I think it was a very good start to the summer.
Yeah, despite the unfortunateness that happened in Wildwood.
Yes.
Have you seen the video yet? I know when we talked to you about it earlier, you said you hadn't seen it yet.
I actually have not seen it. I've read about it.
Yeah.
As I said the other day, very disturbing. You also saw some actions by this, if you believe the video, and no reason we shouldn't, by this young woman.
Yeah.
So the wheels of justice are churning as they should. I'm of the opinion there's no reason to be spitting at a policeman.
Yeah.
But also the other parts of that were quite disturbing, and let's see where that takes us.
But that should not overshadow ultimately what has been a very good report from Shore Towns up and down.
100%.
Yeah.
And I was hanging with a fair amount of mayors, in particular Mayor Reed in Point Pleasant, Mayor McGovern in Belmar, Mayor Vaz in Seaside Heights to pick three. The reports were largely good. Seaside Heights had a little bit of an issue with one of their establishments. And by the way, it also shouldn't, the overwhelming percentage of either police on the one hand or beachgoers on the other hand are good citizens in the police case, putting their life at risk every day doing stuff for their communities that we should laud them for. There's always going to be something here or there, and we got to make sure that that's called out and the wheels of justice turn properly.
So here you are five months, almost 6 months into your first term. What has been the thing that has surprised you the most that you didn't anticipate when you took this job?
I think, and Eric, I'm not suggesting it's easy or that we've got all the answers or that we haven't been surprised, because the answer to all the above is that's all been the case. But we had it pretty well scoped out, I think. The fiscal surprises were all negative, so we haven't found any pots of money, but we expected. I'll give you a heartwarming one, my best example is adding a list of ailments to be eligible for medical marijuana. Mm-hmm. People walking up to me in diners and saying, "Hey, Governor, you changed my life." I mean, the direct line, the immediacy between actions you take and the impact on our 9 million residents is quite stunning. I knew that. Obviously, it's a huge responsibility, but that really strikes you. I would also say we've been battling hostile winds coming at us out of Washington more than probably I guessed we would. But otherwise, I'm incredibly honored to be in this position. It's an extraordinary responsibility, and we take it as seriously as we can and should.
And you're negotiating, your first budget. You're kind of in the home stretch now, about 4 weeks from the deadline. On the spending side, a lot of focus has been on school funding numbers. Senate President Steve Sweeney held a news conference just a short time ago announcing he and the Assembly Speaker had a deal on a funding formula, would have a bill to you next week. It would modify the current funding formula by eliminating some of the features that have distorted how the money is distributed. For example, districts getting paid for students that are no longer in the district. Your initial reaction to what you're hearing out of the Senate president today?
So I didn't see Steve's press conference, and I haven't seen the bill yet. But I'd actually broaden it to say that we've made very good progress among the Senate, the Assembly, and our front office over the past couple of months. We've been very much in the middle of those discussions. The folks listening in some communities are pulling their hair out, and I don't blame them. This has been a problem that's been building for years and years and years. Basically, two pieces of this. Number one, the formula didn't get funded. It got underfunded by over $9 billion over the past 8 years. So one piece of the answer has to be more money. We put our budget out with $200-something million more. The other piece is the formula is 10 years old.
Yeah.
And as you suggested, and I think the Senate President, the Speaker of the Assembly, and we all agree that that needs to be done in a way that is thoughtful and is reflective of 2018. When we put our budget out, we have to do that in the context of almost 40 years of constitutional legal history. So there's the way that the template in terms of how that money is spent that's put out has to adhere to the current formula. But I'm on the side of all the folks who are mad as heck about their kid not getting the money they deserve, and we aim to fix that.
So there will be at least some redistribution, and the net is there are some districts that may see less than what was promised after your budget.
Yeah, I think the answer to that is it's going to be an equitable distribution, much more so. You can't solve this also. That's the other message I want to – we can't solve this overnight. I'll give you just back to the underfunding piece.
Yeah.
Our budget envisions a four-year ramping up to fully fund the formula, in addition to whatever tweaks to the formula you're making across communities. So we're going to get there. We can't solve everything overnight, but we've had good cooperation. I think we all see this in a similar way, and I'm highly confident we'll get to a good place.
All right. 1-800-283-1015 is our telephone number. Let's begin with George in Howell. George, you're on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, George.
Hey, how are you guys? How are you, Governor?
Hey, George, how are you?
Okay.
Exit 98, George, right?
Yes, I'm actually on 195 right now.
All right, man.
Headed home. I have a question for you. I was in a serious car accident almost 3 years ago.
Mm.
I had to have triple fusion in my back. I'm trying to get Social Security disability, and I've been told now I still have another 18 months or more left.
Oh, man.
Which is impossible to keep my home, and my wife is doing everything possible.
Yep.
Is there any way you know someone that maybe you could put me in contact with?
100%. George, let me say this. First of all, God bless you. You're in my prayers. Secondly, I should have said this up front, Eric. Our entire cabinet is listening in, as is our front office. And so I'm going to ask two people, George, to follow up with you, if you don't mind. Number one is our Human Services Commissioner, Carol Johnson, is probably the right person on the disability and benefits side. And by the way, we're not magicians, but we owe you you deserve an answer, and it sounds like you deserve a different answer, I have to say. And secondly, I'd love it if you wouldn't mind, George, our health commissioner, Dr. Sharif El-Nahal, to also contact you just on the health side and see if there's any good ideas that he might have. Does that sound all right to you?
That'd be great. The last 15 years before I had to retire, I was a local 172 laborer.
Oh, man.
Best job I ever had. And unfortunately, I cannot do the work anymore.
God bless you.
It's very depressing.
Please, if you see any of your local former colleagues, give them a high five for me, and I'll ask Carol and Sharif to follow up and get you within the next 24 hours.
Great. All right, George, thanks for calling Ask the Governor. Lisa in Browns Mills, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, how are you? How you doing, Governor?
Hi, Lisa, how are you?
I'm doing well. I have a question for you.
Please.
I lost my daughter Sabrina to a heroin overdose 4th of July 2013.
God bless her.
I've been fighting for an involuntary bill. I know that that Congressman MacArthur sent you a letter to encourage you to adopt this bill. I'm wondering if there's anything that you can do to help us with getting more beds, more accessible treatment centers for people that don't have insurance. Not only did I lose my middle daughter, but my youngest daughter took to the heroin. Thank God she's been clean since November now. But, I mean, she left out of 14 different facilities.
Yep.
There needs to be a way that we can get them into a treatment center and make them stay there, and we cannot jail our way out of this.
Yep.
We need your help.
God bless you, Lisa. Most importantly, God bless Sabrina, and I'll keep your other two daughters in our... God bless your daughter, Sabrina, and your other two daughters in our prayers. I've not seen the letter from Congressman MacArthur, but I'll ask our team to track that down for me, and I look forward to reading that. We announced, Lisa, a couple of months ago, a $100 million program directed at the opioid crisis, and a lot of the elements that you referred to, the frustrations, lack of beds, lack of inpatient medical-assisted treatment, et cetera, are elements of that. We need to do a better job. This is a raging epidemic in our country. I was at a National Governors Association meeting two or three months ago, and if you were looking for common ground, unfortunately, the opioid crisis was probably the most common ground all 50 governors shared, regardless of political party, regardless of geography. It's a problem that's been raging in our inner cities long before it got to places like where I live in Monmouth County, where it's a huge epidemic. But I will read that letter. We have put a program in place. We are being aggressive about it. I'm a believer, by the way, that medical marijuana can play a role both on the inbound as an alternative to some. I've got a family member who had a surgery recently. This is not a heroin example. It was an OxyContin example. They were dispensing them like M&Ms. You know, what alternatives do we have for that? And then if someone is addicted, on the way out of that addiction to recovery, I think medical marijuana could play a role in that. And we're trying to aggressively push that. Again, more beds, more Narcan, a limitation on the number of days. Governor Christie dropped it to 5 days. We support that in terms of the painkiller. And of course, there's a law, you know, with heroin, there's a big law enforcement element to this as well, not just education and prevention. Hang in, Lisa, and you're in our prayers.
All right, Lisa, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. 1-800-283-1015 is our telephone number. We'll continue with your calls for Governor Phil Murphy in a moment. Now here's New Jersey Fast Traffic.
Route 35 is still closed in the Neptune area each way between Westlake Avenue and Bangs Avenue. This is a tractor-trailer accident. This report is sponsored by NJM Insurance Group. Traffic on the parkway still a bit slow north in 149 with a crash being cleared. 22 in Hillside. A lot of westbound slowdowns to watch for in Route 1 construction in South Brunswick. 42 north, pretty tough at Route 55 at a 295. It's a crash on the shoulder. Ben Franklin Bridge roadwork slowdowns leaving New Jersey and still pretty good across the Hudson. This isn't just insurance. It's NJM, and they're here to help make every moment extraordinary. Learn more now at NJM.com. Traffic every 15 minutes. Next report at 2:33 from the RayKatina.com Auto Group Traffic Desk on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5.
For over 50 years, Princeton Orthopedic Associates has been making sure life doesn't happen without you. If back, neck, or nerve pain is slowing you down, our advanced training and expertise in spinal surgery, including minimally invasive treatments, will get you back in action. Our top-rated orthopedic doctors, in collaboration with Penn Medicine, take a whole-body approach to help move you beyond your spine and nerve pain. To schedule an appointment at one of our 5 locations, visit POAMD.com.
It's your local Ford store's Memorial Day sales event. A great time to find an incredible deal on a new Ford car, truck, or SUV. Hurry in for great financing, low lease rates, or bonus cash on an adventure-ready Escape, street-savvy Edge, or spacious and versatile Explorer. Plus, huge savings on Ford trucks, making now the time to get into America's best-selling brand. Go to buyfordnow.com or visit your local Ford store today. Claim based on 2017 calendar year sales.
How would you like a second paycheck without having to work a second job? Does that sound just about too good to be true? Well, my friends at Online Trading Academy can show you how other people are doing this every day. You see, they have a patented core strategy that can help you learn how to follow what the big banks on Wall Street are doing and how profits are being made when the market goes up and even when it goes down. Right now, they are offering a free Wall Street Insider Kit so you can get started right away. Call 888-286-9955. You'll get 2 online classes, instructional videos, and a guide that will help you learn to build that second income. It's all free. Call 888-286-9955. They will even throw in 2 free tickets to an upcoming workshop so you can ask questions and learn more. Call 888-286-9955 or go online to otaclass.com. The market is making all kinds of moves. Are you ready to move with it? Call 888-286-9955 or otaclass.com.
New Jersey, 101.5 instant weather, scattered showers and thunderstorms possible through the afternoon. 70s expected statewide, a few 80s in the southwest. Scattered showers and thunderstorms for tonight, low 65 to 70. Warm and humid on Friday, on the watch for showers and thunderstorms. Highs 82 to 88. Slightly cooler Saturday with scattered showers and storms. Highs 76 to 83. Chance of rain on Sunday. Cooler temperatures. Highs 70 to 75. From the Edison Heating and Cooling Weather Desk, I'm meteorologist Richard DeWeather.
In Rumson at 66, Kingwood 69, Robbinsville 73. Traffic and weather every 15 minutes on New Jersey 101.5.
Now, more with Governor Phil Murphy and Eric Scott on New Jersey 101.5.
1-800-283-1015 is our telephone number. Governor, I know that we were talking to Lisa just a minute ago.
Add one thing I meant to say to Lisa, and I hope she's still listening. I'm going to ask Dr. Sharif El-Nahal to also follow up with her because he can give her a lot more detail on the programs that we're putting in place.
Awesome. Let's talk to Robert in Ewing. Robert, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, Robert.
Hello.
Hey, Robert.
How are you? Nice to speak with you.
Sure. Nice to hear from you.
Let me preface my question with my little side business of being a landlord, which as a businessman, I'm sure you can relate. The numbers right now on property taxes are 1 out of 3 in property taxes, right off the gross. And then that's before PSE&G, who keeps raising their rates, and insurance, which keeps raising their rates. And it's kind of become a case of, what am I even bothering for? Everybody's taking all the money. But let me preface that with a bigger concern. The state budget, which is in, you know, dire need of some cutting, is there any plans to cut back on some of the spending? Because it seems to me like we're just going to keep spending ourselves into oblivion, and eventually, you know, we got to pay the piper.
Yep.
And we could end up like Puerto Rico or similar places like that, where nobody will lend us money anymore because we spent too much of it.
Yep.
So is there anything on the agenda for that? Do you have any sort of plan to reduce that debt completely if we could?
Yeah, well, listen, completely would be a huge accomplishment. I'm not sure that's going to happen overnight. But, Robert, this is an issue that's been building for decades, and in particular over the past decade. On the one hand, we're not a low-cost state to live in, and probably never will be.
Right.
But we used to be a state. My wife and I moved to Monmouth County to plant our flag to raise our kids 20 years ago. We were a good value for money state. You paid a premium, you got a lot back. And on some days, we still are. Save the Children just ranked New Jersey as the number one state in America to raise a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Number one in America, looking at health, nutrition, safety, etc. So to some extent, we still get some return for that premium, but the premium keeps going up and the return, frankly, has shrunk over the past decades and increasingly over the, in particular, over the past decade. So the answer is we're going at it. I don't want to give you a long diatribe, but we're going at this a number of different ways. And by the way, you can't raise revenue and keep doing that to get yourself out of this box. We got to grow this economy. We got to run this government like adults. Get back to that good value for money place. So that's a lot of different ways to get at it. Property taxes. We've, in our budget, increased the ceiling on the deduction from $10,000 to $15,000. We've named two property tax czars who are meeting with mayors every day, a Democrat and a Republican, trying to find cost savings. We're putting an enormous amount of investment into the innovation economy to grow the economy. Let's not underestimate how lack of growth over the past decade has hurt our ability to pay our bills, meet our obligations, and pay our debt down. I could go on and on and on, but there's a lot. Fully funding public education is a good example. Mm-hmm. Underfunded by $9 billion over the past 8 years. That sounds abstract. It's not if your kid's not getting the money they deserve to give a good public education, and it certainly isn't working for you given that the average property tax bill is 53% of it is your public education expense. So fully funding that helps you. State government has been stripped over the past 8 years. That doesn't mean we can't be better. We're going to put in place a new technology team. We're trying to streamline processes to pick two examples. Be smarter, particularly with technology. So I believe with all my heart, our best days are ahead of us, that we will again be a good value for money state, not the low-cost state to live or do business in, but good value for money. Probably won't be there overnight, Robert, but we're going to get there.
I think the concern, and you can hear it a little bit in Robert's voice, and mm-hmm. you can hear it to folks that we talk to, is it's not an affordable state right now, and it's only a good value if you can afford to live here.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you look at the budget that you put out, forecasting revenues will grow by $2 billion. Tax increases about $1.5 billion of that. But if lawmakers don't want to go along with that, and there are some that don't, what will that mean for that $661 million in additional appropriations that you're seeking?
Yeah, so let's set the frame here. We've had, particularly the past 8 years, we're coming out of a fiscal mess, number one. Number two,
but you also know that every governor that ever comes into office says that about the last guy.
Yeah, I've only done it once. All I can tell you is it's
okay.
True. I know it's true this time.
Okay.
I've only lived through this movie. I've only seen this movie once.
Okay.
But it truly is. I mean, we're downgraded 11 straight times under the past administration. And the fact of the matter is, where did people really suffer? The middle class. And the dreams, like myself growing up with a dad who didn't get out of high school and a mom did, of the folks who aspire and look up to get into the middle class. They paid the price, underfunding public education, stripping NJ Transit of its budget, mm-hmm. and look what we got for that, of virtually bankrupting the Transportation Trust Fund, to pick three mm-hmm. examples. Our budget this year is a reset to say, time out, we're going to get back to doing what we always used to do really well, and we're going to load up an investment again into the middle class and the dreams of those who look up and aspire to get into it. You need revenue for that. Revenue has to come from a couple places. One, tax fairness. So if you're the very wealthiest among us, and I mean literally the very wealthiest, the big corporations, a hedge fund, we want you to pay your fair share. It's not tax warfare, but we want you to pay your fair share. We want to undo tax gimmicks. I think the sales cut tax, just so that my predecessor could say he didn't raise taxes when the gas tax went up, is a gimmick. That wasn't good public policy. That hurt the middle class. Let's fix that gimmick, and in exchange for that, put a historic investment back into the middle class. And I think those are all achievable. I really do, and I think we will get there.
So are you confident, because there are some non-recurring revenue significant in your budget. Are what you're saying is that you believe that you will be able to grow the economy enough between now and when we're going through the budget next year that revenues will increase to have this spending sustainable without the need for more tax hikes?
So I don't want to be, because I love being here and I love being with you. We have an all-time modern low of non-recurring revenue in our budget.
Yep.
It's a very low number. And there's a reason for that. We're a state that the rating agencies used to trust, our citizens, our kids, and we've lost that edge. I want to get back to the place we used to be, where say, you know what, adults are in charge. It may not always be easy or pretty, but they're doing the right thing. They're good stewards of our state. So we want sustainable revenues. And then I believe with all my heart, there's evidence all over. We opened a new medical school up in Nutley and Clifton yesterday.
Yep.
That's going to be a booming innovation hub. We've got an innovation hub that we're launching with the local community and players in Rutgers in particular in New Brunswick. I believe we absolutely will grow. But with sustainable revenue, average, getting back to an average growth rate, and doing smart things like sports betting, like legalizing adult use marijuana, getting our medical marijuana regime into the right place. We do all of that for other reasons, but they have the added benefit of generating revenues, and we'll use those revenues, and that'll go toward the investments that in the future that we need to make.
Okay. 1-800-283-1015 is our telephone number. Do we have time to take a call? We need a break here, Bill. We need a break? Okay. All right. So I know Mike in Bridgewater, hang on. I know you want to talk to the governor about some budget cuts. We'll get to that coming up in a minute. It's 2:31 on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5.
When it comes to the success of your small business, you make every dollar count. So what could you do with $10? It may not sound like a lot of money, but it's enough to turn 500 strangers into 500 connections. All it takes is the right business card. Go to Vistaprint.com today and you'll get 500 high-quality custom business cards for only $9.99. You heard right, 500 business cards for $9.99. That's less than 2 cents per card, but don't let the price fool you. Vistaprint uses only carefully selected inks and paper stocks, so your satisfaction is absolutely guaranteed every time for any reason. You'll find dozens of designs that are just right for your business at Vistaprint, and you can add your logo and contact information with just a few clicks. It's never been easier to turn strangers into connections. Just visit Vistaprint and start today, because this offer won't last forever. Get your 500 business cards for just $9.99 at Vistaprint.com. Use promo code 8787 at checkout. That's Vistaprint.com, promo code 8787.
It's time for some straight talk. Some wireless companies offer free phone deals. Sounds pretty sweet until you find yourself locked into a pricey long-term contract. Not so free after all. With Straight Talk Wireless, you can own the latest smartphones for a low monthly payment, and there's no contract. Cancel anytime, no penalties. Check out our wide selection of the latest smartphones at straighttalk.com. Everything for less.
This is a lease-to-own transaction. Customer will not own the device until all payments are made. Please see terms and conditions of service at straighttalk.com.
Attention all authors. Page Publishing is looking for authors. Have you written a book and want to get it published? Page Publishing will get your book into bookstores and for sale online at Amazon, Apple iTunes, and other outlets. They handle all aspects of the publishing process for you. Printing, cover art, publicity, copyright, and editing. Call 800-501-3689 now for your free author submission kit. That's 800-501-3689 for your free author submission kit. Again, 800-501-3689.
From the RWJ Barnabas Health Studios, this is New Jersey 101.5.
Clara Moss Medical Center earned its 10th A grade from the Leapfrog Group. Clara Moss Medical Center and RWJ Barnabas Health, achieving excellence together.
New Jersey 101.5, Ask the Governor will resume right now. New Jersey, fast traffic.
Panuva closure, Route 35 of the Neptune area between Westlake Avenue and Bangs Avenue. It's a tractor-trailer accident being worked on. This report is sponsored by Amazon Fulfillment. Traffic along the parkway overall moving along pretty well. 22 West and Hillside. You've got roadwork slowdowns, and the traffic is also bunching up a bit on 195 now coming west in towards a 549 in Howell. That's an accident being cleared out of the way. Ben Franklin Bridge, roadwork now cleared, leaving New Jersey, and all is well across the Hudson so far. Now hiring warehouse associates at Amazon in Robbinsville and Florence. Visit Amazon.com/Jersey Jobs. Traffic every 15 minutes. Next report at 2:48. I'm Tom Rivers on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5 instant weather. On the watch for a few showers and thunderstorms here this afternoon. Mostly 70s, but a few 80s expected in the southwest. Scattered showers and storms will continue through the night tonight. Low 65 to 70. Warm and sticky on Friday. Scattered showers and storms in the forecast. Highs 82 to 88, and more showers and storms expected Saturday. Highs 76 to 83. Cooler temperatures Sunday with a chance of rain. Sunday's high 70 to 75. From the Edison Heating and Cooling Weather Desk, I'm meteorologist Richard DeWeddon.
In Long Branch, 65. Pennsville, 74. Scotts Plains, 68. Traffic and weather every 15 minutes on New Jersey 101.5. New Jersey weather brought to you by the jewelry store at Martinsville. This is it. The final weeks are here. They're going out of business. Stop what you're doing. Hurry in before they're gone. It's your last chance to buy the jewelry of your dreams, discounted at 60 to 80% off. The Jewelry Store, 1944 Washington Valley Road in Martinsville.
Now, more with Governor Phil Murphy and Eric Scott on New Jersey 101.5.
Governor Murphy in the studio for a special edition of Ask the Governor. 1-800-283-1015 is our telephone number. Let's go quickly to Mike in Bridgewater. Mike, you're on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy.
Hello, Governor.
Hi, Mike. Hey, Mike. How are you, man?
Hello, Governor. Hi. I got a quick question, though. What are you going to do about the wasteful spending with New Jersey Transit? Like, I'm currently an engineer with Class 1 Railroad.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, New Jersey Transit, their engineer program, they have a fail rate of over 50%. Why not try to recruit people from other railroads that, you know, we can slave money on the training and stuff like that, since there is such a shortage of engineers at New Jersey Transit and other crafts?
Yep. Great question, Mike. Thanks for your patience, by the way, for the commercial break. NJ Transit's been one of our top priorities. In fact, I think if you look at the events that we've done, I think NJ Transit and transportation generally top the list. Listen, it's a tragedy. It went from being viewed by many as the premier commuter rail and bus system in the country to being a laughingstock. And it was a combination of a lot of things, including stripping the state support of NJ Transit, leadership that didn't have a transit or infrastructure or transportation expertise. The cupboard got bare, as you rightfully point out in your question, the sort of highly skilled positions weren't being filled, or filled by the wrong folks. And that's not to say there aren't thousands, and there are, because I met a lot of them over the past years and months, of good, earnest, hardworking folks who go to work in NJ Transit every day trying to do the right thing. But it was a leadership and a funding issue. We put new leadership in, got a guy from the private sector, Kevin Corbett, who's from AECOM, a lot of infrastructure transportation experience. Diane Scacchetti, who's our acting commissioner of transportation, is the chair of the board. They've got it open to hire for a whole range of skilled positions. In fact, if Diane is on, I would love Diane, Mike, to give you a call and just walk you through in particular. And by the way, get your advice. There may well be something you're seeing that we're missing, but we're on the case. This is a classic one, Eric, where we're not going to get there overnight, but
well,
we begin
the long
process back.
We're poaching our engineers.
100%.
You know, our engineers and conductors, I mean, even the MTA, how many did the MTA
100%. By the way, Diane herself is a good example. She ran the New Jersey Turnpike, not a transit, but Turnpike.
Right.
She was poached by Florida seven or eight years ago. So we're now starting to get some of that back on our side, and we'll get there. Thanks, Mike.
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Thanks for calling. Let's talk to Hal in Hamilton. Hal, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy.
Hey, Hal.
Good afternoon. Hal. Good afternoon, Governor. How are you?
I'm well, sir. How are you doing?
All right. Hal, question. Governor, my apology. There's a state school in West Trenton, New Jersey, School for Deaf Children.
Yep.
It is costing the state hundreds of thousands of dollars. It is overstaffed. The student population is hovering under 100. There's many vacant buildings on the property that's not being used. And I'd like to know what have you personally been to the school and seen the waste and the deficit?
Hal, first of all, thank you for the question. I have not. I've driven by the school not once or twice, but probably 20 or 30 times, and shame on me for not going in. I've never been asked this question before. I'm not aware of the mismatch between enrollment, and God bless the kids who need to be enrolled in a school like that, and the investment. Our education commissioner, acting commissioner, Dr. Lamont Repelette, is listening in. I'm going to ask Lamont, Hal, to follow up with you and get back to me. It's a fair question. I don't know the answer, and we will get back to you.
Okay. All right, Hal. Thanks for bringing it up. Christina in Middletown. Christina, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, Christina.
Hi, how are you, Governor?
Hey, Christina. You know, I'm a Middletown guy.
Oh, yes. Yes, I know.
Nice to hear from the hood.
I love it here. I really do. Yes. I just had a question about family leave insurance. I had my daughter at the end of March, and when I called in, they told me it was going to take 13 weeks to receive my benefits, and I'm only home for 12. I was just wondering why it takes so long, because it's supposed to help me while I'm home to care for my newborn, and we're not going to receive it for 13 weeks. So it's put a little hardship on things. So I was wondering, is there anything that could speed it up to make it faster?
Yeah.
Because I've been home for a little while now. So I was just wondering about that.
Christina, first of all, congratulations. That's the most important thing. But secondly, that's a ridiculous reality. The whole point is to take care, to give you a break while you're home financially. So that's crazy. I'm going to ask, let me just think for a second. I'm going to ask Christine Norbert Beyer, who's our commissioner in Children and Family Services, to give you a call, if that's okay, Christina, and go through that with you.
And
Christine, if she's not the right person, she'll get it to the right person. We got to figure that out. That's crazy. I don't blame you for being frustrated. By the way, do you have a boy or a girl?
I had a girl. Her name is Olivia.
Olivia. All right. Welcome. I look forward to meeting Olivia back home sometime.
All right, thanks, Christina. Thanks for calling. Michelle in Manchester, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, Michelle.
Yes, hi, Governor.
Hey, Michelle, how are you?
Thank you for taking my call. I am good. The reason I'm speaking with you today is regarding the park exam.
Yes.
Back when you were campaigning for governor, you stated that you would eliminate this test on day one of your governorship.
Yep.
That has yet to happen.
That is correct.
What's the stalling? What's the stalling? Why, why is this not being eliminated?
Yeah, listen.
This test is useless, and it has really no purpose for our children. It hurts our teachers by basing their evaluations and test scores.
Yep.
That's not fair to our educators.
Yep.
I mean, you're supposedly a pro-education governor. You're hurting our students and our teachers by continuing to administer this exam.
Yep. So, Michelle, I have not changed my opinion one bit on Park. And listen, I've got four kids under the age of 21. I want my kids tested and assessed. But like all of us, I think we want it done in a meaningful way so that we're not teaching to the test. You know, a white knuckle experience once a year. Oh my God, I've got a bad day. And then that impacts the kids, you know, everything from his graduation prospects to how the school year is going to look. It impacts potentially the educators' performance assessment. There's a whole bunch of reasons. I'm a bigger fan of lower stakes, more frequent, quicker feedback assessments that focus on learning and not teaching to the test. I haven't changed one bit on that. The problem is, and I'll admit, when you're on the outside, maybe this is Eric on the list of surprises.
Mm-hmm.
Not everything you think you could do on day one, it turns out you get done on day one. So this was already contracted for this school year. To some extent, I think the questions are contracted for one more year. But our commissioner of education, and again, I'm going to ask Lamont Repelette to follow up, Michelle, with you and just go through this in more detail. But we are in the process, led by Lamont, over the next number of months. I think 6 months, having an open discussion as to what's the right testing regime in this state. Again, my huge bias as governor is lower stakes, more frequent, quicker feedback. Let's focus on learning and not teaching to the test. I'm in complete agreement with you. It's just a little bit more difficult to get done than we thought.
Well, and we heard this issue now facing East Brunswick and other districts where freshmen who had taken the Park test thought they were done as a graduation requirement. some kind of a miscommunication there, and now they're trying to get these sophomore students back over the summer, if possible, to take this test. Are you aware of that issue? Is that something that the education commissioner is trying to figure out?
100%. Again, I'm not a believer. I think you need to pass a lot of hurdles to be qualified to graduate from any school.
Yeah.
High school, certainly. Any level of school. But a white-knuckled high-stakes test is not on my list. So Lamont is on that case, is the answer.
Are you expecting – does he have the authority to be able to overrule that and say, no, as a freshman, that should be good enough?
Yeah, I don't know the particular case as it relates to the specifics of East Brunswick, so I don't want to get out over my – I don't want to practice without a license, as they say.
Sure.
But he himself is a former superintendent, in his case of Asbury Park.
Yeah.
He's got deep roots, by the way, in Middlesex County. He'll know the players. And I'm confident that we'll get a sensible solution.
All right, excellent. Mia, Tom, Kathy, hang on. We do have to take a break for traffic and weather, and then we'll be back with Governor Murphy and your phone calls on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, it's Bill Spadia. You've heard me talk about Trinity Rehab. Now I want to tell you how they are different than everybody else. Have you been somewhere else, another rehab center, maybe to the dock, and you didn't get any better or you got worse? You've got to call my friends at Trinity Rehab. At Trinity Rehab, you aren't just a number. You're not just going to get exercises and then have the therapist walk away. No, Trinity Rehab is interested in your recovery, and they're going to work with you as a team. The weather's getting warmer. I'm back outside running and biking. It's great, and I'll tell you something. It wasn't going to happen without the help of Trinity Rehab and their Alter G machine and EPAT. You've heard me talk about this non-invasive shockwave therapy that's approved by the FDA, and it's used for so many different problems, whether it's your back, your knees, your shoulder, strained neck, tendonitis, and problem solved after only 3 5-minute sessions. At Trinity Rehab, you don't need a prescription to get started. They're growing and adding locations to better serve the community. Check out trinity-rehab.com and find a location near you, or call them at 800-518-0977. That's 800-518-0977. They're now open in Marlton.
Hurry into Macy's newest shopping experience when Macy's Backstage opens Saturday inside Macy's Freehold Raceway Mall. The first 200 customers score a Backstage scratch-off card with a chance to win up to $25 off your Backstage purchase. Join us for music, food, giveaways, and get a free Backstage tote with any purchase all weekend. Macy's Backstage opens on the third floor inside Macy's Freehold Raceway Mall, Saturday, June 2nd at 10 a.m. Details in store. Visit macysbackstage.com.
Hi, I'm Patrick Fingles, owner of New Look Home Design. Customers always ask, Patrick, when's the right time to replace my roof? Here's the truth. There is no right time. There's only the wrong time, when it's already leaking. Now you're not just replacing the roof, you're dealing with water damage too. So why wait? I get it. Just because you know it's time for a new roof doesn't mean your wallet feels the same way. I've been asked, Patrick, can I pay you half now and half later? So I started thinking, why don't you pay me half later and half never? Through May 31st, we're cutting 50% off the price of all roofing materials. And the half you do pay, you can pay us later with no payments, no interest for 12 months. Call New Look Home Design at 1-800-279-5300. That's 1-800-279-5300. NewLookHomeDesign.com. Through May 31st, pay half later, half never.
From spaghetti sundaes to afternoons at the aquarium, your family's at the heart of all you do, and your heart is at the center of all we do. Introducing cardiac partners at Cooper and Inspira. Our services range from diagnosis and advanced heart surgery to cardiac rehab, with top physicians, convenient locations, and more treatment options. Cardiac partners at Cooper and Inspira, the heart of South Jersey. Visit cardiacpartners.org or call 833-SJ-HEART, 833-SJ-HEART.
I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
Did you take those big down payments?
You're darn right I did. And I'll do it again.
Your Honor, Sansone Juniors. Sansone Juniors Easy Auto Center in Keyport clearly states it's a crime to pay more than a dime. One dime down.
Lock them up. And at Sansone Juniors Easy Auto Center, I'm granting credit amnesty.
If you bring home $350 a week, you get up to $30,000 in credit.
$30,000.
Congratulations, agent.
So, What's the beat on trade-ins?
At Sansone Junior's Easy Auto Center, you can get out of that lease, get out of that loan today.
Even if you still owe thousands more than it's worth.
Thousands?
Yes, thousands. With only one dime down.
It's a crime to pay more than a dime. One dime down.
Only at Sansone Junior's in Keyport.
Sansone Junior's Easy Auto Center in Keyport.
Exit 117 off the parkway.
Easy to get to, easy to call. 800-335-EASY-EASY.
Or jrseasyauto.com.
Qualified buyers. Download New Jersey 101.5's podcast, Speaking Millennial, with Bill Spadia, Jay Black, and Jessica Nutt. Sponsored by Flemington Car and Truck Country, family of brands in Flemington.
New Jersey 101.5 will resume with Ask the Governor coming up after New Jersey Fast Traffic.
Good looking afternoon so far up and down the Garden State Parkway, New Jersey, Turnpike and 287. This report is sponsored by NJM Insurance Group. We still have a closure, though, of 35 in Neptune between Westlake Avenue and Bangs Avenue. A tractor trailer accident, 22 West and Hillside. We've got roadwork slowdown. Still have a down pole and wires affecting Route 10 and Whippany on the eastbound side by Algonquin Parkway. 80 West and Patterson, a crash, and 195 on the westbound side just after Route 549. And Howell, you've got a crash. Not bad across the Delaware or the Hudson so far. This isn't just insurance, it's NJM, and they're here to help make every moment extraordinary. Learn more now at njm.com. Traffic every 15 minutes. Next report at 3:03 from the RayKatina.com Auto Group Traffic Desk on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5 instant weather. Scattered showers and thunderstorms possible through the afternoon. 70s expected statewide. A few 80s in the southwest. Scattered showers and thunderstorms for tonight. Low 65 to 70. Warm and humid on Friday. On the watch for showers and thunderstorms. Highs 82 to 88. Slightly cooler Saturday with scattered showers and storms. Highs 76 to 83. Chance of rain on Sunday. Cooler temperatures. Highs 70 to 75. From the Edison Heating and Cooling Weather Desk, I'm meteorologist Richard DeWetter.
In Belmar, 67. Willingboro, 75. Bridgewater, 68. Traffic and weather every 15 minutes on New Jersey 101.5. New Jersey weather made possible by Reproductive Medicine Associates of New Jersey. Having trouble getting pregnant or staying pregnant? With success rates nearly 20% higher than the national average, the experts at Reproductive Medicine Associates can help. For more information, visit rmanj.com.
Now, more with Governor Phil Murphy and Eric Scott on New Jersey 101.5.
Hour is quickly coming to a close. Governor, again, thank you for coming in to talk to folks tonight. Or this afternoon. Hope you'll come back and do it Sunday.
Eric, I would just say a couple of things. One is I'd love to come back at night because I know you don't have to run the weather and the commercials. And secondly, I hope that whenever it is, the weather is better. I've heard now the weather forecast four times.
Yeah.
It's not getting any better over the course of our time together.
Yeah, over the weekend.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Let's go to Russ in Frenchtown. Russ, you're next on Ask the Governor with Phil Murphy. Hi, Russ.
Yeah, hi, Governor Murphy. Thanks for taking my call.
Hey, Russ. How are you, sir?
All right. The question I have for you is, would you be behind a proposal 10 years from now, any new state employee goes on a 401k and is not in a pension plan? Everyone that is in a pension plan will remain there until that runs out. So everyone in the future is on a 401k.
Yep. So I've never been asked the question, Russ, what I do it 10 years hence, which is an interesting interesting dimension to that question. That question X years hence, by the way, has been discussed about whether or not communities would consider doing things like merging or merging services right. X years hence, so right. that the current generation of political leadership didn't have to pay a price. My overarching issue, Russ, is that the pension crisis has been building for 20 years on both sides of the aisle. We've kicked the can down the road continually. We have constantly left the public sector employees at the altar, proverbially. I feel like we've lost the trust of too many. I mentioned earlier rating agencies and young people, but in this case, in your question, public sector employees. So I want to see us get first, before we have sort of theoretical discussions, I want to see us fully meet our obligations. That doesn't mean we're blind to what we could do in the meantime. We're announcing, if it hasn't been announced, we're announcing all hands on deck health benefit
this morning.
This morning, commission with folks represented from all different perspectives. We are firmly of the opinion that we can be smarter as it relates to the health realities of our public sector employees, frankly, more broadly in the state for all of us. But when I say we're smarter, where you can pay the same or even potentially less, that the state, the Holy Grail, you pay the same or less, God willing, less. The state also saves money, and you get at least the same coverage, if not maybe even in some cases better coverage. We think there's a lot of opportunity for that. It's a $3-plus billion annual spend on health care benefits.
Well, I mean,
in the state.
The numbers don't lie. I mean, your own Treasury Department says the funds have about $6.6 billion in revenue from employee and government contributions, but around $11 billion in benefits are being paid out to retirees. Yeah. You know, that unfunded liability is going to grow even when the pension fund investments are going well. Can we afford really to wait to let that gap keep growing?
So this is back over to the pension side. As I said, I think the more immediate savings are in health benefits. That's what we want to tackle right now because we think there's enough evidence that we can get it. And the answer is we want to do this the right way, but we've lost our trust. We've lost our credibility. I chaired the original commission on this, and you and I have talked about this 13 years ago and sat across the table. It was a big issue then. But it was, you know, it was, I would admittedly say more abstract then, even though it was as big as it was. But the theme was the same as it is today, even though there are now more zeros. We have broken our trust. We've broken our commitment, and we have to get back to being the state that folks trust.
All right. Let's make Kathy in Sicklerville our last call for the hour. Kathy, you're on with Governor Murphy.
I'm glad on your last call, segueing into trust and, you know, commitments and gimmicks.
Hey, Kathy.
Yes or no question. Yes or no question. I'll make it quick. And please do not pontificate on, well, we got to do this, we got to do that, we got to do this. Are you going to stop the bear hunt as you promised? It's the only reason I voted for you. I'm a Republican, and it's the only reason, and people are watching and calling.
Yeah.
Are you stopping the bear hunt?
Kathy, I'm going to give you the answer, but I have to give you a parenthetical, and it's just a fact. And so we're trying to figure this out right now. The answer is I am absolutely committed to stopping the bear hunt and to finding other non-lethal ways to achieve the same objective. There is a council, the Fish and Game Council,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Yeah.
I think that's the name of it, which, as it turns out, again, this is maybe on the list of modest surprises. That I was not fully aware of, that holds a huge amount of sway here. And they are not where I am on this. So we're trying to figure out, Kathy, don't lose faith on this. We're trying to figure out creative ways to achieve the objective that I am still 100% committed to, which is to end the bear hunt.
All right. Governor, it is always an honor to have you here talking with our listeners. I will see you again soon, I hope, even if it's just down on the boardwalk.
I would really look forward to that. I'm going to channel Big Joe Henry in addition to you, Eric, and it's great to be back.
All right. Thank you very much, Governor Murphy, on New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5.
Follow the leader. Princeton Medical Institute.
Are you between 18 and 65 years of age inclusive and diagnosed as having major depressive disorder, MDD, for which you are currently taking antidepressant medication? Do you or your doctor feel that your current antidepressant medication is not helping you as expected? If this describes you, you may qualify for a clinical research study evaluating an investigational drug that may be taken with your current antidepressant to see if you have a greater response to your treatment. Your participation in the study can be up to 15 weeks. You will be reimbursed for your time and travel costs. Call 609-921-6050 or visit them at PrincetonMedicalInstitute.com. That's 609-921-6050.